Hello guys, welcome back to another tutorial video. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to create and print shipping labels in PayPal. So here we are in PayPal. What you need to do is open up your web browser of choice, go up to the browser bar here, and type in www.paypal.com/shipnow. And again, that is paypal.com/shipnow. And then go ahead and hit enter, or just go ahead and proceed to the URL. And then once you're here, it'll ask you to log in to your PayPal account. All right, and once you are logged in, you will be presented with this dialog box here to go ahead and type in the address, the ship address, so the address that you want to ship to here. So go ahead and fill this out here, the country, the name, address, city, state, and email if you want to do that as well to kind of notify them and give them updates on the package or whatever you're sending them. Once you've filled out the form and you've filled out the address here that you want to send it to, go ahead and click the blue button here that says ship to this address, just like this here. You will then see your shipping address, your from and then your to address on the left-hand side here. So you can choose whether you want this to be the same as the return address, or if it's another address, you just hit other and then type in the new zip code there. All of this is contingent on you having an address for your either business or personal account here on PayPal. This is a dummy account here. And so there, you know, address, I just entered a random address here to kind of go ahead and show you guys with the tutorial. Now we're going to choose the different shipping information. So we have carrier name. For me, I'm going to send via USPS, and all of this will depend on where you are located. So if you're in a different country, obviously these drop-down menus will look slightly different because obviously the carriers in Canada are slightly different than those in the United States. Same thing goes for India, Japan, wherever you're located, these may look different. I'm going to select the United States Postal Service. I'm going to select the service type to be priority mail to get it there in a few days. My package needs to be a medium box. Again, you can... What I normally do is weigh my box. I have a nice little scale that I got off Amazon for like 10 bucks. I weigh my package. That way I know how much it weighs and I know that I'm purchasing the correct amount of shipping. Because what'll happen is if you purchase the wrong size or you purchase the wrong type of label for the package that you send, it will be sent back to you. And a lot of times that money is difficult to get back. So I'm going to go to medium flat rate box and let you know package weight up to 70 pounds or less. Do you want tracking? You can check or uncheck this if you want tracking with the specified carrier, if that's even provided. I want a signature on confirmation. This is something that, again, is very important if you want to know, hey, did they receive this or not? And then do you want to display the postage cost on label? I love this. Selling stuff on eBay, this is great. Sometimes you make a little bit of money on shipping and people just they don't like that. So if you don't want to show them how much you paid for it, just go ahead and uncheck this box here. Do you want to add insurance if it's a technology device? If it's an item of great value, I recommend adding insurance up to the value at which you think that item is valued at. And then the mailing date, again, you can select today if you're going to mail it today or tomorrow or a few days in the future. I'm going to go ahead and choose tomorrow. And then what we'll do is we will go to calculate shipping costs. Now, again, this little drop-down menu here is going to be different for everyone, right? So flat rate boxes are going to be a flat rate fee, okay, for this here. But if I choose, say, UPS, they have completely different options, right? So I go to UPS. Do you have an existing UPS account? So yeah, every carrier is going to have different options here. Like if I select first class or parcel service, you can see here it's either a large package or a package slash thick envelope. If I choose this option here, I actually have to enter in the package weight. And then once you go to calculate shipping cost here, it will actually calculate the shipping cost based on this package weight here. So make sure this is very accurate just so you're not worried about getting the package back to you. And then when you're ready, you just hit confirm and pay. Now, when you hit confirm and pay, it will automatically take you to the actual page where you can print the label. So I'm going to go ahead and go to confirm and pay. And then once I do that, it will load up and it will pay it out of either your PayPal balance or whatever payment form you have on your PayPal account. So as you can see here, I have my shipping summary here, the price that I paid. And then I go to the green check here where it says print. If I go to print and the blue button here, it'll bring up a PDF that shows me the printing instructions. I will just go to file, print, print this out to whatever printer you use, and then cut at the dotted line. And then make sure that you don't cover up the little barcode here, this one or the one on top, because if you do, it's going to be hard for them to scan it. Certain carriers have to scan these things when going through the postal system. Now, if you want to cancel a label and you realize that you entered the incorrect weight or you entered the wrong address, or you're like, I don't need to send this anymore. Here on the summary page that you can get back to by just hitting the back button here, is you can see this option here under more options that says void this label. If we go to void this label, it'll allow us to say, why do you want to void this label? Postage was destroyed. I've changed my mind. And then what we can do is we can email the recipient that we have actually voided this label and we're creating a new one. Click the blue void label here. It will be canceled. It'll take a couple of days, but your money will be dispersed back into your PayPal account once you get this nice little confirmation here. So that's everything you need to know about creating and printing shipping labels within PayPal. If you have any questions, please put those in the comment section below. I've got a ton more PayPal tutorials. I will link those down below as well. If this video helped you out, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And I will see you guys in the next video.